All right, everybody. Welcome to Life is Strange Before the Storm. I know multiple people have already probably played this game, but I don't care. I'm playing this goddamn game. I played the previous Life is Strange. I loved it to heck. And the game made me cry multiple times. I know, I'm a little bitch. But, you know, life is strange. Let's see here. I'm just gonna get right into it. I'm really excited. Been wanting to play this forever. Been waiting for this game to go on a deal. Let's go. So we got all three episodes here. Episode 1, Awake, Brave New World, Hell is Empty. Let's go. I hope it's as good as the first one. Life is Strange Before the Storm is a story-based game that features player choice. The consequences of your actions and decisions will impact the world around you. Choose wisely. I will try to mute my mic between cutscenes.
I can't believe Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill. Fuck yes! Mom would kill me if she knew I was out here.
Just checking. Alright, we gotta turn that sensitivity down. Like right there, bam.
Holy shit. This place is awesome. I'm gonna get inside. I'll have to get through that door. That saw looks ancient. I wonder how long ago the mill actually closed.
Betting stuff.
If I owed somebody $1,000, I'd be shitting my pants.
I know you're kind. I know you're bullshit.
Those guys need to get a room.
Oh, he's roasting them.
Or not.
Oh, damn.
Damn.
Mind your own business.
I understand, really. And it won't ever happen again.
This RV's just begging for a little street art. But if I do it here, someone will see me.
Okay. Back here. Oh.
Now what to draw?
Oh, I have a choice.
Definitely, absolutely not a meth lab.
Okay,
guess fire safety isn't exactly high on the agenda here. This place has collected a lot of junk over the years.
Got bikes. I already know about the bikes.
Help you, miss?
You gotta let me in. Check it. I'm totally legit.
It's not a bad fake, kid, but you're in over your head here. Do yourself a favor and scram.
Oh.
Can't let him push me around. Should I go back and stand up to him? Or can something around here help me convince him? An old lumber car. Guess it's been years since anyone's actually worked here.
I mean, I have no... Maybe... no.
Because trust with me is earned.
God, again? What do you want, kid?
Is that your bike over there?
Yep.
It's, pretty cool.
Gee, thanks. Is that all?
This is the old mill, right? I heard Firewalk is playing here tonight. They're awesome.
Nope.
Are you kidding?
You should probably just go.
To convince this doorstop that I'm not giving up until he lets me inside.
In back talk, you use arguments and insults to get someone to do what you want.
Don't you remember what it's like to be a teenager? I just want to see the band.
I thought we went over this. Isn't it past your bedtime?
To succeed, pay attention to what your opponent says. Huh. No bad time. Your bad time. Do me a solid.
Aww. Isn't it past yours?
Real cute. But I still don't know.
Again, listen to your opponent's words.
Kittens riding tiny mopeds are cute. I'm more like... Red Sonia riding a panzer tank.
Okay, kid. I get it. You're tough.
Sometimes the right choices are more difficult to pick out. Here in Playground is a good response to kid.
Maybe I am a kid. Because this place looks like a damn playground to me.
A girl like you? I can't protect you in there.
You mean a girl who doesn't take shit from a walking pair of biceps like you? That kind of girl?
My boss will kill me if I let you in.
Bosses suck. Screw the man and fuck the rules, dude.
You're not accepting no for an answer, are you?
Nope.
And you really think you can take me?
Yep.
What if I had a knife?
No problem.
Gun?
Don't care.
What if I had...
You could have a flamethrower, an army of robot ninjas, and a motherfucking dragon on a leash in there, and I'd kick your ass.
I give up. You're all right, kid. Go on in.
Oh, wow. Did better than I expected.
This is intense! Shit!
Hey, Delia! Come!
Cute dog.
Ah.
Just follow the lights and the sound. Can't wait to get in there and thrash. That dog is fierce. Sober up, girl. You're missing the show.
That's exactly what we need, thank you. Yeah, I mean, they're gonna sell out.
Hey, are you selling
20
anything?
$20.
What?
$20 for a t-shirt.
That's really expensive. Dick.
No. Look, we have to set this up exactly as I expected. It's not gonna take any more.
Sweet knife. Just like the one my mom refused to get me for my birthday.
Please.
Okay.
Yo, Frank.
Hey.
Chloe?
I know your name, you idiot. You bought pot for me every month for a year. Look at that getup, studs. You're trying too hard. What are you even doing here?
I'm here to see Firewalk, man. They rock.
How'd you even hear about this little shindig?
God, the internet. How else?
Seriously? Fucking kids.
So, you come here a lot, or...?
Yeah.
Right. It's cool.
I'm really glad you approve.
Okay, so, you holding? I could definitely use something to take the edge off.
Of course. As soon as you give me the $175 you owe me.
Shit. Do I really owe him that much? Unless I find some quick cash around here, I can kiss my high goodbye. How about you spot me some? You know I'm good for it.
No way. I learned my lesson last time. Money first.
Never mind, Ben.
Suit yourself.
Looks like that parking brake is the only thing keeping that car from rolling down the ramp.
Alright, it's not gonna take... Hey, I told you $20. You looking to get beat?
That guy's a dick. If I want a shirt, I'm going to need to get creative. Sorry, dude. Maybe you shouldn't overcharge.
Shit! No! Come on!
Thanks for playing, dick. Oh, yeah! Sweet, sweet victory.
There's cash.
That's like $200.
I mean, would it cause more problems? Your actions will have consequences!
Holy shit, I'm rich.
Screw it, I'm not gonna buy weed.
No thanks. I try to avoid hepatitis when I can. Here we go. Fuck.
Look at this guy.
Hey, you okay?
I'm fine.
Relax. You bumped into me, remember?
Yep. My bad, dude.
You don't know who I am, do you?
Nope.
Who I am?
Don't care either.
Let me know how that works out for you, bitch.
All right. Mosh pit is a no-go. Fine. Maybe I can get a better view of the action from up above. You should be more careful. It's a rough place.
I don't like your attitude.
Hey, I'm sorry about the beer, okay?
Not good enough. We're not done.
Come on, dude.
Show you how unimpressed I am with limp dick assholes who get butthurt over a spilled beer.
I think she's calling us out, dude.
She's gonna regret every word. Every word.
Oh, this is gonna be good.
I'm gonna teach this little punk some manners.
I'm serious. You wanna see me get angry here? Because I'm getting there. And it won't be pretty. It won't.
She thinks she can take you?
Okay. Thank you. Is Rachel with me? Nope.
Sometimes, all I want to do is shut my eyes and tell the world to go to hell. Daily rituals are important, even when they involve writing unread letters to friends who have forgotten you.
Max, the loser. Yeah, that's right. I called you a loser. Want to know why? Because you weren't you weren't at Firewalk last night. Even Frank was there. He's my dealer, or mom. If you're reading this, here's my dealer, and you shouldn't be reading this. Or here, why did I say here's? I am too fucking tired. He's my dealer, and you shouldn't be reading this. It was maybe the greatest night of my life. I hiked to this old mill using the train tracks, then verbally abused this dumb bouncer until he left me inside. Firewalk was the shit. Who knew ragers like that went down in little old Arcadia Bay? Fuck Seattle. Plus, I have a sweet ass black eye for a souvenir. NBD. But there were these two assholes, skeevy guys, whose manhood I wrecked. I don't know what NBD is. Oh yeah, and I got rescued by the most popular girl at school. How was your night, loser? Firewalk plus Chloe and Max. Wow, I actually get to probably learn about Max here a little bit. There's so many Max stuff. Dear Max, Dad got me this stationery one day when I complained about wanting to send an email and the internet was down. And tonight I thought, hey, maybe it's time to write Max. The funny thing is, I don't really know what to say, because we haven't talked in 3 months despite all my calls and texts, and not that I'm upset or anything. Fuck, there's no way I'm sending this, is there? Chloe, the unfriended. Damn. Ready? So mom suggests taking a road trip next summer, and I'm like, cool, I guess. But then she starts talking about David being there. Yes, that David. The wannabe drill sergeant who swooped in on mom and has stuck around like a bad zit. David, the mustache monster from Planet Dipshit. That fucking David. Anyway, I politely suggested to mom that perhaps it was too early to assume David would be in the picture by them. Or breathing. Hey, shit happens. As you might imagine, that didn't go over well. But really, if this guy's still around 3 months from now, then she's got serious self-esteem issues and got serious self-immolation. Look it up, nerd. Plants. She could do better. That's all I meant. But she didn't want to hear it. Like I'm the asshole. Chloe the asshole. So you know how I stopped going to class so much? Like, stopped talking to me so much. Or, like, you stopped talking to me so much. Funny story, I've had trouble coming up with an excuse. So I just didn't. I just didn't show up. And it was fine. Nobody said anything to me. Crazy, right? It's like I'm invincible all of a sudden. Maybe that's the perk of being the dead dad girl. No one knows what to do with me, so they're actually relieved when I stay home. Wish I'd figured this out sooner. Think of all the wasted school time. P.S. Priest or Pris from Blade Runner popped into my head last time I rubbed one. Oh my god. I mean, at first I was thinking about Deckard and the smolder of his. But then Pris just totally stole the show. Probably nothing there. Think I just won her bangs. Chloe, the electric sheep. Yeah, that's right. I called you a loser. Want to know why? Because you weren't a firework last night. Oh, it's just repeating now. Okay. So we got Chloe. My name is Chloe Price, but you can call me... I am an inmate at Blackwell Academy, currently serving a 4-year sentence for crimes against matrony. That would be my mom, Joyce, who seems endlessly disappointed in me. Which I get it. I'm no one's image of a perfect daughter or student or anything really. But who the fuck wants to be perfect? I'm surrounded all day by so-called perfection and it sucks ass. Other things that suck. Mom's new drill sergeant boyfriend, David. How hard is it to buy weed around here? Having no friends, hypocrites, country music, people who say chillax, dad being dead. It's been 2 years since he died in a car crash and I still think about him all the time. I've even been having these weirdly lifelike dreams. Sometimes I think he's trying to tell me something. Other times I remember that he's feeding worms in a ditch right now. And anything else is just a fairy tale to make myself feel better. At least I have two weapons to help me survive this shit Burke town. The pen I used to tag any and everything I want. And my shining personality. If I work at it, maybe I can leave this place just a little less perfect than when I found it. Then you got the drug dealer. You got the mom and dad. There's Max. Okay. Max Caulfield, MIA. Ex-best friend. Extraordinary. This artsy motherfucker loves photography. Or photography. Photography. More than life itself and definitely... what is that? Is that war? I can't... And definitely more than... Is it... More. Okay. More than life itself and definitely more than me. She even uses old instant cameras. It's probably not healthy for anyone to be that stuck in the past. But who am I to tell people how to live their lives? When we were kids, we would dress up like pirates and eat ice cream and write and draw these stupid comic books where we had powers and saved people and shit. Then my dad died and her dad got caught and got some job up north and she moved away to Seattle. It was probably the moment when I needed her most and she bailed. Thanks, Max, for teaching me that I can't rely on anyone. I mean it, life lesson learned. The worst part is that even though we haven't spoken in months, even though she habitually ignored my texts so much that I just stopped trying, even though I know deep down that she doesn't care about me anymore and that she probably has all new friends up in fucking Seattle, I still miss her. If she came back tomorrow and said, hey Chloe, want to dress up like pirates and be stupid together, I would take her back in a heartbeat. Lub dub. Man. There's the dad. Damn. I feel worse about Chloe, like, I feel her. I didn't think about Chloe in that way, like, emotionally, in the old Life is Strange. But, I guess that's a good time to call it, and this is a new start of a story that I'm excited for. Thank you for watching. Come back next time. In Life is Strange, Before the Storm. See ya.